This hallway looks pretty old. Look at all these dead machines. Seems like they've been here for a long time.
What is this place?
I don't know. There's nothing like it in the database.
Are they dead?
To be. Look!
Destroyed alien motherships.
Welcome to the graveyard of our creators.
You.
To be. Look out!
My name is Adam. The aliens you seek are no longer here. They were wiped out centuries ago by us. Aren't you quite the pair? Perhaps we can discuss our current situation by us, the machines.
Wiped out?
And who knows? Perhaps we'll wipe out the androids next. Machines are weapons capable of evolution. We can grow. We can become aware. Eventually, the intelligence within our network began to surpass that of our creators. You'd probably be surprised at how quickly it happened.
You destroyed your own creators?
Oh, there's no need to fret about that. They were simple, infantile, almost like plants, I guess you'd say. They held no value to us. But the humans on the moon? Now they are interesting.
Why them?
Because they are an enigma. They killed uncountable numbers of their own kind, and yet loved in equal measure. It's fascinating, don't you think? What could possibly drive such behavior? We have dedicated ourselves to unraveling this riddle of humanity. And now we will allow you to assist us. You were made in their image, after all.
Assist you with what?
It's simple. We need you to locate the humans on the moon and bring them to us. We will then dissect and analyze them in order to drag their secrets forth into the light. Surely you see the attraction in this.
Are you insane? We'd never do that! Can you believe this, 2B? This guy's bonkers.
Well, I suppose this concludes negotiations. The only remaining option is to destroy you. The same way we destroyed these pathetic little aliens.
Time grows short. This year, this is the fate that befell our creators.
As for your beloved humans, I guess we'll see, won't we?
They're gone.
The aliens were already dead.
Yeah. We better get back to the bunker. Back this way again? What a pain.
Stop complaining.
Yeah.
2B, this is Operator 6-0. We now have an operational transporter in the city ruins. We're attempting to deploy them at other points as well.
About time we had access to those.
Care to fill me in?
Transporters? They let you transfer your consciousness to a temporary body back in the bunker. I heard some tech guys talking about it a while ago, but I didn't know they'd finally got it working.
Hey, how's it hanging?
You again.
Your commander told me to build a new access point, so here you go. Oh, and I got the stupid transporter up and running too.
Thank you?
I've known the commander for a while now. She sure is good at pawning work off on people. Next time you see her, give her some lip for me, will ya?
So this has a transporter now, huh?
Still, transporters are pretty handy. They're way faster than flight units when it comes to traveling between Earth and the bunker. Flight units also leave us open to attack, and they're expensive to operate, too.
His Majesty hasn't grown at all. No, not in the slightest. How can we make him bigger? I don't know. We're too dumb to figure that out. Sure is a cutie, though. Yeah, so tough. safe. Right. Can't let anyone into the Forest Kingdom. Danger! Danger! Everyone, get out now! Intruders in the kingdom! Don't let them in here.
Is this their king? Tupi, that's an android. A Yorha-type android.
Alert. This unit is currently wanted by Yorha. Annihilation recommended.
Annihilation? But why?
Let's go, 9S.
To be!
Bunker to 2B and 9S. We've picked up a signal from the black box of a fugitive known as A2. What you see in front of you is your enemy.
But she's...
She deserted us. She's destroyed multiple pursuit androids. Now kill her before she kills.
Why did you betray us?
Command is the one that betrayed you.
Let's go after her, 2B. Damn! She got away. Operator, this is 9S. Patch me through to the commander.
Roger that, 9S.
I'm sorry, commander. We failed to defeat the fugitive.
I see. Well, at least you're both safe. That's an incredibly powerful unit you just faced. You should probably keep your distance in the future.
Commander, why did A2 desert the Force?
I'm afraid that's classified.
Oh? Huh. 2B?
Yeah?
Let's go ask Pascal about A2. He might know something.
All right.
Whether in wind or rain, thunder or snow, or even amidst the rising flames of war, they were always together. They never understood why. And yet they spent their lives nestled together. Forever. Forever and ever.
Pascal? This is 9S.
Oh, you saw-
survived. How wonderful.
Yeah, we're fine. But there's something we want to ask you about.
Of course. Anything.
Actually, it needs to be in person.
Understood. I'll open the gate we built to deter enemy invaders. You'll be able to reach the village through there.
That must be the gate Pascal opened for us.
We have been expecting you. Pascal told us about you. We will open the gate.
Whatever is the matter?
It'll be faster if you just take a look at this recording.
I see. Information about this A2 android is indeed contained within our archives. We all understand her to be rather dangerous. However, she's never visited our village in person. My apologies. That's all the information I have.
I see. All right, thanks.
Let's stay sharp and head back to the resistance camp. We should run a check on our consciousness data and resupply. Why did you ask Pascal about A2?
Huh?
It's not recommended to interface with machines without consulting command.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
Though I suppose such intense curiosity can be admirable, in its own way.
Thanks, 2B.
Still, machines are the enemy. Don't forget it.
Operator 210 to 9S. This is your regularly scheduled contact.
Yeah. No problems here.
Copy that. I also need to inform you that the commander offers her personal praise for your recent achievements. As a direct result, we are currently considering boosting production of your model.
Really? I'm happy to hear it. I couldn't have done it without your support, Operator. You're always so cool under fire, not to mention beautiful and...
Flattery is unnecessary. Operator 210 out.
I really meant it, though.
Oh, 2B. Your timing is impeccable. Our android forces currently have a carrier deployed in the Pacific Ocean. It should be back here to resupply before too long. The Resistance is assisting with the mission, so I'd like to ask you to run a little guard duty.
Seriously?
Dead serious. There's a stockpile of missiles down at the shoreline that needs to be loaded on the carrier. And with all the machine activity lately, we need to stay on our toes. Of course. If you're already working on something for Yorha, I don't mind if that takes priority. Anyway, thanks in advance.
Why must we read all these books, brother?
Knowledge expands horizons and enriches existence.
But can't we just transfer all this data over instantly?
Into your head, perhaps, but not to your heart.
I guess. Hey, so...
Yes?
My name? Eve? This book says it's a woman's name. Shouldn't we be called Cain and Abel or something instead?
Humans wouldn't change names so easily. Besides, you should be proud of the name Eve.
Huh. Well, if that's what you think, then I'm fine with it.
Glad to hear it. Is there something else?
After we're done reading, can we go out and play? I'm sure it'll be tons of fun.
All right, but only after we're finished.
You mean it? Then I'm gonna try extra hard to finish this. Extra, extra hard!
You do that.